but spring was near. To conjure up its endless strings of green magic handkerchiefs. Would you only see what I see? You would surely know about me. I think I must have caught a glimpse of heaven.
We're protesting Caligula because it is the first hardcore porn film to run in a commercial theater in Vancouver. It's our chance to ask the government why they don't keep the law. We are addressing the Attorney General in particular. We are also getting to our political representatives at the provincial level, as well as our Crown Council and those that have the involvement with the law. We're claiming that hardcore pornography dumped on us by Bob Guccione, the fellow with the Penthouse magazine and his millions, is something Vancouver doesn't need. We have community standards. Community standards are mentioned in the law, and we're asking that we maintain community standards. This film is worse than most people could ever imagine because it involves violence, rape, bestiality, castration, every kind of sex activity that involves itself with violence. It's hardcore pornographic. Therefore, United Citizens for Integrity are asking that the government take action to close Caligula down. It was history as well as this. Now, the Apocalypse Now didn't show the whole war, it didn't show everything, but it showed enough, you know what I mean? So all I'm saying is this might have shown a few bad things, but things could have been worse. We didn't live in those times. We didn't live in Vietnam when the war was on and Apocalypse Now was filmed and stuff, which had a few bad reviews.
You just wait till Armageddon comes.
I'm
just trying to draw comparisons like Apocalypse Now.
My friend, one of our workers in the church is a high school teacher, and she went in to see it. And
so
she said that all
yourself.
Around, yeah, I'm speaking for myself.
Yeah, go see it and then tell
yeah.
me about it.
My friend, all you got to do is read what it says. Read what it says on the window.
You know
they don't lie about it.
You're gonna yeah. die.
If someone tells
it teaches
you,
violence,
hey,
rape, perversion, bestiality, and torture.
If you, have
you see? You're arguing around and around in circles like a dog chasing his tail, my friend. You're not getting anywhere.
To put it another way,
it doesn't make sense what you're talking about, my friend.
Someone tell you to jump off a building.
If you haven't seen the movie, you don't know what you're talking about. Yeah, Sunday night, and I thought it was all right.
Well, of course you would think it's
all right. So go see it and then come out here and tell me about it.
My friend, I don't need to see it because they tell me what it's about.
You're saying you got to try it to know what it's like.
Personal experience for most people.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know if you jump off a building, you're going to wind up dead or seriously injured. You have to try it to know what it's like.
That's health reasons. Medical.
What's dope? It's going to hurt you. I've had people I know.
Go see it and then tell me about it.
If you love the Lord, then you don't bother
go
with this
Go see it and then tell me about
friend.
It. You can't tell anybody about something you haven't seen or done.
You take a stand against
filthiness. There's people like you that talk about drugs, they haven't even fucking tried them yet.
You take a stand against
filthiness. You know, you can't tell me about pot if unless you've tried it.
We told them not to take it.
If you've tried it, then you can share some
ideas. We're older than you, and we told them not to take it because we've been around more than you have.
It doesn't matter. It
does. Absolutely, it matters, my friend.
I used to look at all this kind of pictures. These are live pictures, but I used to look at this type of pictures, and I tell you, it depraved my mind. My mind was going bananas.
Do you want to give me an example? Do you want me to give you an example?
Other people.
Yeah. All right, and I can prove this happened. I used to be a driver on the road. Okay, I had two trucks of my own, and I was pulling a load from Vancouver to Calgary.
Yeah.
And I was going up over the Rogers Pass, and I just started going down. So, you know where you go through the tunnels? I just started going down the other side, and I broke an air hose on my air. And I got and that truck was freewheeling. Okay? I got a full load of steel on. It's right in the summertime. Campers coming up both sides of that highway, going up and down. I had no control over that truck. I jumped, mister, at 35 miles an hour. And I said to myself before I jumped, I said, oh God, please don't let anybody be coming up or I'm gonna kill a few people. And do you know, I jumped, I hit the pavement, I rolled. And the last thing I remember before I lost consciousness, brother, was campers coming up. And that truck missed every one of them, went up over the bank, and flipped over, and nobody got killed?
I don't know.
Now, you tell me whether there's no God or not. Man, there is some power that's beyond us. Believe me.
Well, sir,
And then you have to cleanse your brain out of all this garbage and sickness. And it depends on how polluted your brain is already.
The Lord made the mind, and he has put down standards in his word that the mind should be fed with. And these are not things that the mind should be fed with, like bestiality and carnality.
As far as I'm concerned,
there is no bestiality in it. There
have you seen it?
Yes, I have. There's none.
Well, how would you define bestiality?
An act of sex with an animal of some type.
Well, it says there's things like that going on, like human bestiality.
Not. Yeah, that's why.
Human bestiality.
Listen, this doesn't make any sense because people, you don't have to go and see it.
That's right.
Nobody's
sitting there with a gun saying you can't go and see it.
But we see the results of this kind of stuff going into our kids. You know, the drug culture, the sex culture, all this stuff.
You don't have
people
to
imagining vain things.
Why should you be telling me? Are having some type of law enforcement, I can't go do this type of thing. If I want to,
it's a free society. If you want to go and see it, you can go and see it. If you don't want to see it, you just don't walk by it. You don't, you know,
well,
it's your money, you can spend it and do what you want.
Society is reversing its laws today against people that have a standard, and yet it's reversing the laws to let people go do this kind of thing. And, why do the people imagine a vain thing?
Yeah, exactly.
Canada is a free country.
And there's been more people killed over religion than there ever has over a movie.
If you want to read something, you can read it.
Religion?
You can't have the government come in. If the government wanted to come in, they'd do the same thing with this.
Well, they're promoting homosexuality with the government.
What's the matter with that?
Brought that in. What's the matter with that? It's against God's word. He judged Sodom and Gomorrah for the same sin, for the same reason.
Well, the thing is this, whatsoever a man sow, that's what he shall reap. The people, if you just sow weeds, you're not going to reap tomato. You sow filth, so you reap filth. The people wonder how come there's so much crime and dirt and filth and people robberies. It's because what they have sown in those movies and those magazines is exactly what they have reaped today.
You say if he created the world.
Because I want to
you don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, you see,
there's the devil come out in you.
Mock me like that.
My, you don't
You just finished saying
that if God created the world.
Yes, if God created the world.
But he did create the world.
No, you're a dogmatist.
No, you believed in Jesus, right?
I said if.
No, you said you believed in Jesus, right?
Go ahead.
You said you believed in Jesus, and then you said, if he created the world, well, he did create the world. There's no ifs or buts about it, brother.
My dear friend, there's a lot of people
that don't
believe in Jesus.
And I'm not mad at you because you hit me in the face. Imagine what would happen if I hit you back. I'd kill you, but I wouldn't because I love you, brother.
Put your hands on me for Christ's sake.
I love you, brother.
I'll smack you again.
No, I love you, brother. You see,
we're not here to argue.
No, in Jesus there's no hate. In Jesus there's no hate.
We're not here to argue. You believe God in the world?
Oh, you better believe it.
Everybody.
Those that don't want to be,
everybody,
they can be.
All right, I believe 100%.
Even God
left them. We're the creation.
Accordance of heaven.